Hello YouTube, this is Optimus Smythe, aka Alex, back for another video review. Today, it's another SD Gundam which I ordered off eBay, and I am the first to review this guy, actually, on YouTube. I don't suppose many people even have it, really. I guess it wasn't that popular. It's a Pawn Leo from SD Gundam Force. Now, like I said, I'm the first person to review it. You can't find any other reviews, and you can't find any, like, pictures or anything of them on Google. Well, you can find some, but not that much. And, you know, it's like, these guys don't really get enough love, the Pawn Leos do in the fan base, really. But, oh well, I got them anyways, because I think they're cool. And it actually turned out a lot better than I thought because of all the items he comes with, except for that thing. I'll get to that later. Now, the Pawn Leos, it's like Zako soldiers. There are many of them. They're all pretty much the same, weak, stupid, but really funny. It's said, though, that they're stupider than Zako soldiers are. They might be more powerful, though, because they can do more, actually. They've got more weapons. They can turn themselves invisible. And there's several different kinds. There's one that looks like this, and then there's the leader pawn, which I'll get to in a minute. And then there's, like, the blue ones. The normal pawns that look like this have the crossbows. And then there's the leader pawns, which have the swords and shields and the frills on their heads. So yeah, these are Pawn Leos, and they're just like Zako soldiers in also that they're really funny. They're comical. They've all got different voices, but they all call themselves pawns, and they say pawn all the time, just like the Zakos say Zako every time. It's funny. And it's cool, because one of them, there was this one episode where one was sent out to, like, go into, like, on a stealthy mission to get, like, the spirit egg of LaCroix. He sounded like Waspinator, which sounded funny. And, yeah, if you don't know who Waspinator is, obviously you don't know Transformers too well yet. But let's get on with the figure itself now. Here is the basic pawn, as I refer to it, or just a normal pawn, or an archer pawn, I guess you could say. They just look like this. They don't have a frill on their head. Both shoulders are gray, and yeah, I'll get to that in a minute. They're pretty short, but they're taller than Zako soldiers, especially with the frill. They're almost as tall as normal SD Gundam figures, but just a bit shorter. The legs certainly are shorter. And you can see it's pretty little and cute, as you can see. And it does kind of look like some kind of a soldier. And on the back, you can see he's got this little cape, which is hilarious. Yeah, and if you press down on that cape, something really cool happens. Watch. He switches out different expressions. I don't know if you can see it too well. It's kind of... There we go. If I put my hand over. He's got a swirly mark if he's, like, dizzy or something. And now there's an X for, like, if he just got hit. Like, he's dying or something. Or, well, not dead, but he's hurt. Or maybe he's angry or something. And then there's just normal. So, like, dizzy. Oops. Yeah, this thing likes to skip around a lot. Dead or something. And then normal. Actually, that shouldn't be his dead expression. This should be, because the funny thing about Pawn Leos is this is so crazy. They're so weak. If they get hit once, even just a little bit, they'll puff into magic dust and become a die. A die. Of all things in the world, they become a die, because supposedly it's their true form, as Zero puts it. They're little dice. They're black with yellow spots, and as you can see, actually, I made this thing custom out of Crayola Model Magic. He didn't come with one, which kind of disappoints me, but I made this, and you saw it in my stop motion. It's so funny. They're still alive, though. They can talk when they're in their die form. Yeah, die, no pun intended. But I guess they can turn back into this, but I don't know. They just, if they get hit just even once, they'll puff into their little die form. And now, let's get on with the rest of the figure with his articulation. The head cannot move, unfortunately, because of its gimmick. But shoulders will turn there, they'll go out. They'll swivel right under the shoulder at the bicep. And they've got double hinges in the elbow, double joint, like that. And then the wrist will swivel. The waist swivels also, but as you can see, the arm moves when you do. That's the same gimmick that the good Gundams have, like Captain Zero and Baku. But you can still, like, skip it up a ratchet so that you can have him hold his sword up but have his waist still be in the front. The legs are on a bond socket joint. They'll go in and out forward and backward pretty good, and they're on a ball and socket joint down there at the feet, which isn't terrific down there, but the feet are nice and flat, so they should stand pretty well. He kind of wobbles, but you have nothing to worry about them falling over, really. So yeah, that's pretty much it for all the articulation. Now, this is a basic pawn mode. I'm going to show you his pretty cool crossbow. Here it is. It's got this really weird, like, tank-type bottle pack thingy. I guess that... I don't know what that is. It can't be storage for the arrows. I mean, arrows don't look like that. I don't know what it is. It must be styled after some ancient European crossbow of some kind that used to really exist. The thing I don't like about it, though, is it has... This is the arrow. It's a bullet. It's not shaped like an arrow. In the show, they were arrows, but this is what it is. It does shoot pretty good, however. It shoots pretty good. You heard how hard it went on my reviewing table or the box. And the crossbow itself still is really nice, though. It's got this little crosshairs on top and then, like, a handle on the bottom. And there's the handle for it to go in the hands. So here's the pawn, Leo, now with his crossbow. They can hold it just in their hands. And, yeah, it's just a basic crossbow. It's really cool looking, though, and I like how they use crossbows. So there he is, ready to shoot. And I think most of the basic pawns are pretty much like the infantry and their archers and stuff like that. That's pretty much all they do. So now let's take that out and then give him a quick appearance change. All you gotta do is take this like Roman helmet style like frill and just stick it in that little hole up there. And for some reason it's spring loaded, I guess because it can be used like a weapon. It can shoot off. I'm not sure why, but that goes in. And then you take off... you can take off either one, but it's on the left shoulder. Take this thing off on the shoulder. It's got two little, like, rectangular nubs that go into these rectangular holes. And put on the red one. Because the captains slash leader slash general commando pawns have a red left shoulder pad thingy. So there he is now in his leader form. Nothing else really changes but the frill and the shoulder. And the fact that they usually use a sword and a shield. Now here's the sword. As you can see, I put it in. It's really tiny and little and kind of dumb. Looks like a gladius sword. But there's his sword. It's nice and shiny though and really silver. And here's the buckler shield now. The only thing is this shield cannot be held by any of the other Gundams unless their thumb is separated from their finger like that. See, so you have to kind of like pinch it in instead of sliding it down the hole in the hand like with most Gundams. So there he is now with his buckler shield and his sword. He looks like a heroic knight in shining armor, and yet he's really not that. The pawns are a lot weaker than they seem. They really are. There's like millions of them though. Obviously they're from Lacroa. Deathscythe and Lord Talgis command them, and Lord Talgis are the basic ones like this, leaders and the normal pawns. Deathscythe has like red ones though that are archers, and they're a little bit better, a little bit more powerful. They still become die though when you hit them dice. So that's it basically for the pawn. They're pretty cool. Good luck with finding them. I think I got the last one, unfortunately, on eBay at least. You might find them on eBay again sometime. I wouldn't try looking for it unless you're really desperate. Good luck. Good luck. You're not going to have an easy time finding them, though. These guys are so obscure on the market now, on the internet. They're not in American stores anymore. I think something happened to the Gundam franchise, but you could probably find them off some site. But like I said, good luck with that. So yeah, that's it for my review. That is the Pawn Leo, an excellent figure, and that is all. I'll be seeing you guys. This is Optimus Smythe signing off.